Wow, what a beautiful morning. The sun's already shining on the tiki porch. Temperature already 61 degrees. Supposed to reach a high of 80 plus today.
I'm thinking even Boston has a shot of hitting the 80s out there.
Which makes today the perfect day to go out and do a little bit of exploring. But today's Salem's Detour is going to be a little bit different. I'm not going to be showing you the same old stuff I show you in every Salem video. Today I'm going to be bringing you to places that I've either never been before or only showed you once in a detour, and it hasn't been any time recent. So I'm excited to explore new stuff and bring you some stuff that's, you know, not a repeat episode of a Salem Detour. Here's some exciting news about the city of Salem. No longer do you have to wear a mask while you're walking around outside, and starting next week, you're walking around inside of a restaurant or a shop, masks are no longer required starting the 29th. It appears that outdoor dining is no longer an option here at Red Sandwich Shop. The last year or so, there would have been a big white tent out here where these cars are parked. Well, I told you last week they dropped the mask mandate if you're walking around outside in Salem, but the whole state of Massachusetts, starting next week, the 29th of May, masks are no longer required inside or outside. I mean, just to prove that Red Sandwich Shop is such a great place, look at all these awards that this place has got over the years. We've seen a bunch of Best of the North Shore and our other awards. Here is the kitchen at Red Sandwich Shop. Red Sandwich Shop, formerly the London Coffee House, established in 1698. If you don't want to sit at the bar, there's plenty of other options for dining inside this establishment. Well, I got myself an ice cold Bud Light. Now the question is for food, do I want like breakfast kind of food for lunch, or do I want to do lunch kind of stuff for lunch? There's so many great sandwich options and breakfast options. I don't know, I'm a big sucker for open face turkey sandwiches served with white bread and mashed potatoes and gravy. Look at that steaming hot open face goodness. Wow, that stuff looks so delicious. Yeah. So good. Currently 1:05 in the afternoon. I have to rifle down the street. I have a special ticket to a tour here in Salem at 1:20. All right, I was able to successfully rifle back two Bud Lights and pretty much finish this open-faced turkey sandwich. Probably record time. I would say it was under 21 minutes. Oh man, definitely ate that food way too fast. Again, I had tickets for my very first of three tours today. I had to get out of there real quick so I can walk over to the next destination in this detour. Wow, Rockefeller's is packed outside today with the outdoor seating. Good thing I just ate about 6 seconds ago. What's up, Sam? It's always good to see you. All right, my first of three tours here today in Salem is over here at the Witch House. I pre-bought my ticket for $9 on the internet. That's the only way you can get tickets to tour this house. Also, no video allowed inside, but you can take as many still photos if you want. So that's what I'm going to be doing inside the Witch House today. The Witch House, otherwise known as the Judge Jonathan Corwin Witch House. As I told you in all my past videos, this building right here is where all the plans for the execution of those people who were believed to be witches occurred in the year 1692. He was the judge during the Salem witch trials. No witch was executed inside this house, but this is where the plans for those punishments occurred. A fun fact, this is the only remaining structure from the witch trials of 1692. This house wasn't here. It was moved, I think, just a few feet down the road over to this current location, but the only remaining building during the 1692 witch trials. Here's some information about tickets, how to purchase them, and the days that the witch house is open for tours. If you're going to be visiting the witch house here in Salem before May 29th, that's 11 days from now, you will be required to wear a mask inside. Although after the 29th, if this place choose to do so, they can still make you wear a mask. It is private property, restaurants the same, but I'm thinking the 29th, guys, we're going to be clear of these stupid masks. All right, guys, I'm a little disappointed. No photos, no videos. I know there was no videos going in there, but no photos either. Apparently, you know, they were afraid people were going to be taking selfies inside the witch house, and they didn't want people breathing without a mask on. So hopefully this changes on the 29th of May, just 11 short days from now. But luckily I filmed inside this house, or took several photos from inside this house 2 years ago. So I will upload that section of that previous detour into this detour, showing you the inside of the Judge Jonathan Corwin Witch House. A little disappointed. I wanted to give you guys some fresh pictures. Honestly, it's the same stuff that's been here 2 years ago too. So I don't have a good memory being 47 years old. So all the plaques I read right now, they've already escaped my mind. I will remember one plaque though, that they decided to hang these people that were accused of being witches because they figured the spirits would go up their neck into their skull and then live for an extra 7 years. So that's why they chose hanging as a method for the execution of these people accused of being witches. Another thing to keep in mind while visiting the Judge Jonathan Corwin Witch House is they only give you 10 minutes to check out the interior of this house.
Well, the flag outside the store says it's open. I've never been inside of Witch City Wicks, and you guys have always wanted me to take the detour cameras inside, so here we go. Something I've never done before in Salem. So you guys asked for it, and here we are inside Witch's Wicks. They gave me permission to film, and I told them I was even going to purchase a candle because I am a sucker for candles. This is a candle store. The question is, which candle am I going to walk out with today? Yeah, everybody can use a little bit of dragon blood in their life. Get all your different spell books and books about the occult and Halloween and all kinds of witch goodness. Beautiful lanterns. Taxidermy style butterflies. What are those? What's the actual name of those? I mean, I know they're butterflies, but what's that art called? Is that pinned? Pinned butterflies? Oh my goodness, this incense smells so good. So I asked the employee what her favorite candle was, and she said it's the Holy Grail. It smells like a cemetery after it rains. I took a whiff of it. It's definitely smells like dirt, like if you're a landscaper coming home with those dirty clothes, honest day's work. It's very interesting. If you guys are pin traders, I got a great selection of pins out here. Helping the economy out here in Salem. A couple of amazing smelling candles. You guys need to go in there and buy some candles if you're visiting Salem here any time of year. You know we never pass by the Samantha Stevens Bewitched statue without stopping and saying hello to Sam. Good to see you. Beautiful spring day, Sam. And you know we never visit Salem without stopping inside Rockefeller's. You know I had to stop inside Rockefeller's and get that ice cold Bud Light. Cheers. Wide open seating inside Rockefeller's today. Appears everybody's sitting outside enjoying this beautiful day. I swear Detours isn't sponsored by Bud Light. All right, gonna head back to the car, drop off these candles, head to tour number two. Right over there is the Salem Witch Museum. We're not even gonna stop and talk about it. Check out my past videos. All right, guys, after documenting Salem for about 6 years on this channel, I'm finally taking a tour inside the House of the Seven Gables. As of this date, the 18th of May, you have to pre-purchase your tickets for their tour of the House of the Seven Gables. I bought the $25 tour ticket, which gets you inside the House of Seven Gables, plus the outside garden area. There are certain other tickets you can get without entering the house. You can get just the garden area for, I think it was $10. Or you could actually just walk down the street and just take pictures of the outside house. But I'm taking the $25 tour today. I'm not sure if we're allowed to take video in this part of the tour, but video is just a bunch of pictures, right? 60 frames per second.
Oh man, that was a solid tour. That was a great tour. That was about an hour of my time looking through the original House of the Seven Gables. That's $25 well spent. 60 minutes inside the house. It's a guided tour. A tour guide tells you about the whole history of this house. For once, when it was five gables, then it went to seven gables, then it went down to three gables, and then back to seven gables. So I am super glad that I took this tour of the House of the Seven Gables. Let me tell you why. All these years I've been documenting this house from the outside, I've been saying this is House of the Seven Gables. This part of the house right behind me wasn't even here during the building of this house. This was added on after the fact. This wasn't part of the original Seven Gables. I wouldn't have known that if I didn't take this tour. Even a view from this section right here, that wasn't a part of the original House of the Seven Gables. You're seeing the Seven Gables when you're inside that garden area and looking over. You can't get that vantage point from where I'm standing right now, but well, this is still a beautiful property. Those buildings over there aren't part of the House of the Seven Gables either. Or else there'd be a lot more gables, right? Since they are roof pitches. It's a gable. Anyways, over there's like the kitchen and servant area, and the Nathaniel Hawthorne birth house was moved over here, five blocks from Union Street over to here. That's that house in the distance right there. So that's not an original part of the House of Seven Gables. This is all excellent information I learned today. I guess I could have actually read the whole Wikipedia article on this house and I would have learned this information. But no, I just read, you know, the first couple paragraphs over the years. This tour right here, $25 well worth if you want to learn about the history of this house. I am super stoked I was able to take the House of Seven Gables tour last year, 2020. You could tour the outside in the garden area, but not the inside. And this is simply amazing. If you're visiting Salem any time of year, definitely get yourself a ticket, man. And don't cheap out. Get that $25 version of the ticket where you're getting the whole inside tour too with the tour guide. Good stuff. For our next tour on this Salem detour, we're gonna head down Blarney Street, down towards the Salem Ferry, where we're gonna pick up our third tour of the day. And I think I'm gonna do a costume change right about now. Did I mention we're going on a tiki boat? Ladies and gentlemen, that is our next tour destination for today here in Salem. Captain Scott and First Mate Karen will be taking us out for an hour and a half on Salem Harbor on this tiki barge. It's a floating tiki bar. It's amazing. Now, the reason why this is such a hard ticket to get here in Salem is this floating tiki boat, it only has six stools. I mean, it only fits six people on this boat at any time. I tried looking for tickets for the next 3 weeks to a month for me and my buddy Joey to experience this together. Couldn't pull any tickets except for today. That's one solo ticket. That's why I'm here solo, 1 week after I was here last in Salem. But this is the reason why I came to Salem today, was to get on this tiki boat, this floating tiki bar. You guys are gonna have a good time. If you're looking to book your tiki cruise, here's all the information. It was like $30-$35 for an hour and a half. They get beer, wine, booze, snacks, all on this boat. Great time. Captain Scott, remember detours. Captain Scott, do I have permission to come aboard, sir?
You do. What color lay? You have to have a lay.
Okay, let me take this one. I don't have one of these yet. This color.
Perfect.
All right. Joke never gets old. Just got laid. Man, this is one of my favorite things in the world to do. Look at this.
This is Piper.
Hi, Piper. Hey, Karen. Good to see you.
If you're feeling tiki-ish, we have Painkiller. That's our most popular drink. Still three seasons in. So that's pineapple juice, orange juice, coconut, a couple different types of rum, and some nutmeg on the top. If you don't think you like the nutmeg and you don't have an allergy to it, try it anyway. If you don't like it, we'll get you a new drink.
Sorry. The bar has changed a lot since my last cruise. You digging all the pineapples. That's probably the key. Myself and First Mate Karen and Captain Scott, 6 feet apart. again, the 29th of this month. Whole different story. Maybe they'll let us drive the boat. Probably not.
This right here is our version of the booster shot.
The booster shot.
Last year we called it the vaccine.
Okay.
Right? It kind of fit with the times.
Yeah, yeah.
We had it before Moderna and Pfizer. And this year we have the booster shot.
Yes.
Get the Corona. Cheers. What a peaceful day, just cruising, listening to great music, drinking great beers and great tiki drinks. Over here is a unique view of the House of the Seven Gables, the house that I toured a few hours ago. Don't usually get this cool vantage point from the water, obviously, unless you're on a boat. Remember what we learned today, that this backside of the House of Seven Gables wasn't even part of the House of Seven Gables. When the book was written or when the house was built, that was all added on after the fact. Those are not accurate gables. Those are not real gables. They're the real gables, but not part of the Seven Gables.
Oh, what a wonderful sound.
Sound of the blender as we pass by. Beautiful thing. Right over here is that building that we look at every time we pass the wars predicted in the 1800s. That's that building with that ship out right behind it. We didn't walk by it today with the plaque. Maybe I'll get off and show you that after we get off the boat. Different vantage point that I normally wouldn't have seen. Usually you take that photo from the street. Is that the Loch Ness Monster I see right over here in front of this lighthouse? First mate Karen making me one of those scrumptious Mai Tais. The original style.
Look at that. Thank you, Karen.
You're welcome.
Right there in front of us, you guys are fans of the movie Hocus Pocus. That is Max's house, number 4 Ocean Ave here in Salem. In the movie, you would have seen Bette Midler and the other two witches fly out the top of that roof after obtaining the Book of Spells. Is that what it's called? Or the witch book? I'm not a huge Hocus Pocus fan. I've only seen it maybe one or two times, but right there is Max's house. Different vantage point. Usually I'm taking video from that street. Here we are from a boat, a tiki boat. So Captain Scott also told me this is the birthplace of this tiki boat. He built it right over here in this dock area, this wharf, if you will. I wonder if they're gonna be filming out here for Hocus Pocus 2, which is going to be filming out here in Salem spring, summer this year, 2021. I think they'll be returning out here to Max's house. Put a vlogger in the movie, man. I'll come down here. I'll work for free. Everybody having a good time out here on the tiki boat? Hey dude, you having a good time on the boat? You having a good time? You like Mai Tais or Coronas? What's your drink of choice? To me, it looks like you want a painkiller. Yeah.
Okay. You can take the thing. You have to throw them away because you want to take it home. I'll give you a cap back. Otherwise, throw them in
the recycling. So what do I do with this? Just shove it in my mouth?
Yeah. Guarantee not to hurt your arm.
I'm fully vaccinated back in January. This is, we consider this a booster shot. Ladies, are you psyched for the Rio? I know you are. They were asking for Duran Duran Rio and old school Metallica, and they got the Rio. Her name is Rio, and she's dancing on the sand. It's just me and a boat full of ladies.
Yeah.
Aloha. I'll go on record by saying that that was better than any episode of The Love Boat.
no love happened.
Well, that's going to be it for the Salem Detour. I'm glad I was able to showcase some stuff that I haven't really showed you in other Salem Detours, making this a non-repeat episode of a Salem Detour. Went inside the Witch House, finally took that tour of the House of the Seven Gables, stopped and said hi to Captain Scott and First Mate Karen over at the Salem Tiki Boats. Make sure you take all three of those tours on your next visit to Salem. I'm glad I was able to finally go inside Witch City Wicks. Got some brand new candles. You guys know I'm a sucker for candles. Got the Dragon Blood and the Hearth. This one smells just like a fireplace. I want to thank Captain Scott and First Mate Karen of the Salem Tiki Boats for this sweet Tiki Boat t-shirt. You can buy them on the boat for $25. Look at that artwork. You know what to do next. If you like this video, give it a big thumbs up. Leave a comment down below. I always answer all the comments. If you haven't done so yet, please consider subscribing to Detours. Click that little picture of my face at the bottom of this video. And while you're clicking away, click that small bell. It'll give you instant notification every single time I upload a brand new detour. Check me out on social media. I'm on Instagram at Derek Millen, DerekMillen. I also have a Facebook group, Derek Millen's Detours. And as always, I'll catch you on the next detour.